Hi everyone, in this video we are going to work on creating a bar plot with error bars. So I'm going to give it a title here, bar plot with error bars. And in this video you are going to see me do some simple data manipulation as well as some data visualizations for sure. So we are going to do it in several steps. The first step is to create the data set. If you have your own data set, you can definitely import your data set into RStudio and start working on it. But I don't have a data set here, so I'm going to create my data set right now. I'm going to create the data set using data.frame, and I assign two columns to the data. The first one is the values, and I'm going to assign the values to be 1, 2, 3, and then 2, 3, 5. And then I assign the categories for each value, pretending I actually collected this data. So for the types, I'm going to name them A. Make sure you put the types into double quotation marks so that you know they are categories, not values. So you can see I named them A, B, A, B, C, C. If I run this, you can see on my right side, I'm actually creating a data that has two columns. One column is values and another column is types. And you know, if I want to show this data, it would be reasonable to use a bar plot, like to show the average value for each type. So we have talked about data manipulation and data visualization, because as you can see, for type A, I have two values, type B, I have two values, and so on, so that I actually need to prepare their average value. And if I want to have the error bars, I actually need their standard errors. So we're going to prepare the data by loading a few R packages. The first one is called dplyr, D-P-L-Y-R, and the second one is called ggplot2. Because I have installed those packages, so I can just type library of those packages to have them loaded. If you don't have them installed, then you need to type install.packages quotation mark of that package name. And same thing for ggplot2, you will need to install them first. So you just click that line and click run to start the installation process. And once you finish the installation, you run the library of that package to have it loaded. Same thing for both of the packages here. And then the step two, we are going to do everything in one step. So we are going to manipulate the data as well as visualize the data. So all at once, I'm going to show you how cool this is. So we are going to start with the dataset name. Before you move to step two, make sure you can run the library of dplyr, library of ggplot2 with no errors, like it is totally blue for me. And I'm going to start with the data, and then I add a pipe. I'm using a Mac, so I can do Shift, Command, and M. And then my first operation here is to group by. So actually we are talking about a bar plot. A bar plot, you know, one bar for each category. So we are going to group by types, which is my categorical variable. And then another pipe. And what we are going to do now is to prepare the statistics. So I'm going to use the summary function, which is summarize function, which is under the package dplyr. And then we define one value as average, which is actually the mean of the values. and I define another value named as SE, which is the standard deviation of values over the length of the values that, like, how many records you are collecting. Just to make a note here, SE is defined as standard deviation over square root of n. So I actually missed the square root part of it. So by now, I have defined average, which is the mean of the values, according to group types. So you actually get one average value for each type. And standard error, which is calculated using standard deviation over square root of n. So make sure you close up all the parentheses there. So you can see my last, I have three right-sided parentheses here, and I close up my summarize pair of parentheses. So by now, if you run that, you can see you actually prepared a table. You have types, you have average, you have standard error. The data is pretty simple because I actually made it up. But if you have a more complicated data set, you can see the numbers will be a lot more complicated. But the result will be like this. We have one row for each type, and we have one average number and one standard error for each type. And now we are not going to stop there. We are going to add our graph. So I'm adding another pipe after that, like right here. And then I'm going to do ggplot, a dot. A dot means whatever data we prepared, which is the 3x3 table here. And this dot is just meaning that we are using that table, the 3x3 we are seeing here. A dot and a comma, and then we assign the aesthetic information. Aesthetic information means how are you going to structure your drawing paper. So we have X would be the types. Each type we are going to draw a bar. Y would be the average. The average for each type we are just calculating. So that's X and Y. And we are also going to add fill equals types. Probably we don't really need that. Let's just use this and then add a plus sign. In ggplot, you are going to combine different layers using a plus. So I'm going to type geom underline bar, which means we are going to draw a bar plot, right? So maybe we can just run that and see. Okay, there is an error, which means you actually need to assign the statistics you're going to use to draw the bar plot. So I'm going to, within the geometric bar, I'm going to assign the stat equals identity. Run that. And then you can see you have a very simple bar plot right now, right? And if you want to add more colors to it, you can add fill equals sky blue. If you like sky blue, you can make it sky blue like this. So we actually talked about we want to have error bars on top of the bar plot, right? So we can add a plus sign, and then we can add geometric object named as error bar. So this is kind of another layer. Our first layer is to set up the X and Y, set up the paper. Our second layer is to add the bars. And our third layer is to add the error bars. But for the error bar, we actually need to assign the lower value and the upper value for the error bars. So we want to type aesthetic information again, AES, within the parentheses, we assign y minimum is the average minus standard error if you're using one standard error. Y maximum is the average plus SE, which is like one standard error above the average. So this is how you assign, how do you draw the error bars? What is the ending point? What is the starting point? And you can draw that, you can run. So you can see everything is connected. First of all, we process the data. We actually manipulated the data, prepare our data for drawing. And then we add the different layers of our drawing and we can run it. So now I'm a little bothered by the bars being too wide. So I can add a comma here and I can change that width of the bars. So you can actually change the width as you want it to be. If I let it to be 0.4, you can see this looks much better. The error bars are actually layered up the bars. And you can also do something by changing the theme, right? You can change the theme to classic by adding a plus sign and change the theme. So you can see this probably looks better. And you can also do one more thing by changing the XLab and the YLab names. So by doing that, you can do X equals, so you change the lab names using the function called labs, and then you let X equals maybe bacteria type, I'm just making it up, and Y equals average length. So you can assign whatever name you have, and then you can run that big chunk of our code together by clicking any line within the chunk and run that. So you can see this graph looks so good now with appropriate XLab name, YLab name. We have three types and we have a bar plot with error bars. And just to show you the bars, for B, the error bar for B is actually just one line, because if you look at the data, we have a value 2 for type B and value 2 for type B. So the average for type 2 is 2 with the standard error being 0, as you can see here. So that's why we actually just have one line instead of a bar. Instead of a longer line, we only just have one point. And that's about it. You can actually try to make it your way, like you can actually change the graph according to what your themes are, like change the theme of the graph, you can change the width of the error bar, you can change the color of the bar plot bars also. And you can define your own XLab name and YLab name. And that's it. Thank you.